5 seconds. Start. Madam, the sugar industry, which entirely depends upon sugarcane for its economic working and prosperity, is facing crisis after crisis, particularly in North India, due to the erratic supply of cane because of non-development. The responsibility for the development of sugarcane entirely rests with the government, because the industry is not left with any money at all to spend for the development of cane. 50% of the cost of sugar, as everybody knows, is the cost of raw materials, that is sugarcane. 35% goes to the government in taxes, leaving hardly 15% with the industry to pay for labor, cost of manufacture, chemicals, depreciation, interest, dividend, development, and so on. Obviously, therefore, the responsibility of the government in this matter is very great. The sugar industry of the North, as I have stated, has been suffering from crisis after crisis, and it is a pity that the states of UP and Bihar, which were producing about 19 lakh tons of sugar recently, have come down to a production of 12 lakh tons this year. Is this the way the sugar industry is supposed to be developing in the country? Everybody knows that the cost of production of sugar in the south is about rupees 3 per quintal lower than the cost of production in the north. Yet, when the control has been brought, we find that the prices fixed for Maharashtra and southern region are higher than the prices fixed for UP, Bihar, and Punjab. It is stated that the prices were fixed on the basis of the prevailing prices between January and March this year. But it is conveniently forgotten that the sugar that was sold in the market during January to March this year was sugar produced during 2011-2012. It was not the production of 2012-13, which admittedly was produced at a much higher cost due to lower recoveries and shorter season. It is obvious that when a factory works for only one third of its capacity, it is not possible to produce sugar economically. This problem, madam, is a problem which requires very deep thinking, drastic overhauling of policy, and long-range planning. The only way by which this problem can be solved is by concentrating on the development of yield per acre of sugarcane. There is no reason in the world why India cannot produce 1000 quintals of cane per acre, as is being done by the other sugar producing countries of the world. After all, what is required for the development of cane? It is only good seed, timely irrigation, and fertilizer. We appear to have all these things and resources, and we are doing something about it, and yet the yield per acre, particularly in the northern region of UP and Bihar, has not shown any improvement at all. I submit that if this is the situation, it is high time that the government gave serious thought to this matter and changed its outlook and policies so that we are able to have abundance of sugar and are able to export it. Particularly this year, I am very sorry to say that when the world market prices are so favorable, we have almost no sugar to export, and if we export sugar this year or the next year, we will be doing so at the cost of very steep rise in prices for internal consumption. Madam, there has been shortage of sugar in the past. It has been overcome by us. There has been abundance of sugar, and as is well known, recently there was so much sugar that we did not know what to do with it. Again, today there is shortage, and if this situation repeats itself every 3 or 4 years, I submit that there is a strong case for the government for analyzing the situation, for self-analysis, and for finding out where the mistake lies. I submit that the sugar industry is a highly controlled industry, and therefore there is no initiative whatsoever left in the hands of the management. The wages are controlled, the number of people to be employed is fixed. You cannot retrench people without the sanction of the labor commissioners, and so on and so forth. Every sphere of the sugar industry is controlled, and central government has a very large say in the matter. Therefore, the responsibility of the central government for development of cane is even greater. I have been in the industry for the last 20 years, and I can speak with practical experience that the only solution to the problem of development of sugar cane and the sugar industry is to increase the yield per acre. Unless that can be achieved, we will continue to face the situation which we have been facing for the last 15 years. The yield of sugar cane per acre can be easily increased to at least 600 quintals. Stop.